Hello everyone, welcome back to the channel. In today's video, we're going to be looking at one of the best alternative to Easy Worship software. Now recently I did a video on Bible Shield, which I also made a couple of videos on how you can be able to display your scripture on Vimix, OBS, Prism Live using the Bible Shield software. But the Bible Shield software, it only has the scripture functionality. It does not have a place where you can be able to add your hymn or your church hymn or your local hymn that you can be able to project for your audience to sing along whenever they're singing the hymn in your church. But this new software I'm about to introduce to you is a game changer because it's 100% free. Not only that, you can also use it to project both your Bible and your hymn all at the same time. Okay, so in case you also use, you display only scripture in your church and you don't use hymn or you don't display songs in your church, you can go ahead and use the Bible Show. I also left the video I did on that in the description below. You go ahead and check it out and you can watch that as well. But if your church uses hymn or you display song on the screen, then you can use this new software I'm about to introduce to you. Okay, and some of the features I'm going to show you in this new software, which I think is going to blow your mind. This new software has all the functionalities that Easy Worship has and it's also 100% free, which is one of the things I love about it. In case you're new here, just hit that red subscribe button below and also turn on the notification bell so YouTube will notify you first whenever I do videos like this on this channel. And if you're a returning subscriber, just a quick favor, smash the like button so the YouTube algorithm can also recommend this video to other people on the YouTube community that are searching for similar topic like this. And without any further ado, let's jump right into today's video. The name of the software that I've been talking about is called VastView, and that is the name. Okay, so and this is one of the best alternative to Easy Worship. They also have their mobile app that you can also use as well. Different Bible translation, including English, Malayala, and then Hindi, Tamil, Telugu, and more, and different ones that you can also make use of. And one of the best thing I love about it is that it's 100% free. Okay, so you don't have to pay a dime in order to use this new software. And I'm also going to be making a video on how you can be able to connect it to Vimix, how you can connect it to OBS for those of you that are OBS users, and how you can also connect it to the Prism Live Studio. A quick review on how it works and some of the features I love about this new software called VastView. Now if you want to download this, just all you have to do is to click in the description below. You'll find the link of this software, and once you are on this site, just go ahead and click on the download button here. Okay, go ahead and click on the download button, and once you click on the download button, I'm just going to give it a second to load. Now first of all, you have to download the Adobe Air first. You see this one here, the Adobe Air, you see install Adobe Air first. So you click on this one here to install the Adobe Air both on your Mac or on your Windows. So it's also available on both Mac and Windows as well. So you download it. Once you don't download it, that you can go ahead and download the VastView. Don't download the VastView first without installing the Adobe Air. So you have to install the Adobe Air first before you can download the VastView software, and then go ahead and install it on your PC. I'm just going to go ahead and open the one that I've already installed. Okay, so which is this one here. I'm going to open that, just a second for it to load, and it's actually fast and doesn't consume any of the system resources. It's load really fast, and that is one of the things I love about it. Now this is it here, this is it, and you see these are the Bible here. This one is for the song, so you can even add new songs, new lyrics, whichever one you want to do. If you want to download other Bible version for the software, all you have to do is to go back to the site on this download PC here. You see the Bible database here and the song database. Depending on whichever one you want, you can download the Bible database, and from here you can see it here. So that either you download the King James, the updated King James, the American King James, the American Standard, see the Malayala, BSC on Unicode, and then the Hindu BSI, and lots of them that you can use, the Spanish, the Romania Bible, the German Luther, the Finnish Bible, the Greek Bible, and the Udo Bible, and lots of different versions of Bible, including Vietnam's Bible, Chinese traditional, Chinese simplified. Any old Bible versions that you want is available here. Now all you have to do is just to download it, and once you're done downloading it, you can go ahead. Okay, so I'm just going to show you everything because this is just a quick review, but I'm going to walk you through the process on how you can do that. Okay, so and in the subsequent time, I'm going to make a video on how you can be able to connect it on Vimix and different other software like Prism Live and OBS as well. Now let's go ahead. We've downloaded King James. You click on this Bible here and you see the add a version there. They add a version there. From here we'll go over to the download, and this is the KJV that we recently downloaded. You see, click on open, and this will install the KJV Bible database. Okay, so once you've already installed that, you can just click on save, then you save it, and you can go ahead and close it. Okay, so and that will install that. And if you want to select a particular Bible version that you downloaded, click on the Bible, select a version from here, and you can be able to select that particular version that you've already downloaded. You see the English KJV, which is this one. So if you downloaded the Telugu, the Spanish, the Tamil, so whichever one you've downloaded, just click on the primary here and you can select that as well. Okay, so and this is it. And make sure this display two verse per slide is on tick. That is if you want to use two Bible versions for it. Maybe you want to use one to be English King James, and you want the second slide to be on the local language, then you can go ahead, click on the Bible here, okay, select a version and take this display two verse per slide, and that will enable you to use the two slide on it as well. Okay, and that was another thing. Again, this one is the lyrics, which this part for the songs. Now if you also want to download the song database, it's actually very simple. All you have to do is to go to the website on this download for PC, hover your mouse to song database, just give it a second for it to load, and from here you can download any of the database song database that you want. The Russian with English package, the Arabic hymn lyrics package, the Bengali song package, and then the Telugu song package, different of them, you can download them as well. So once you've already downloaded the package, go ahead and click on song, and from here you can import. You see this import lyrics here, see, import lyrics, and from here you can just select whichever one of them that you've downloaded and you import them here as well. Now how about if you want to add new songs yourself? Maybe you want to manually type them and the database is not available on the website. All you have to do is just click on add and the new button, and you can be able to type all your song here. You can duplicate different slides, maybe the first one, the second one, you can just type all of them, and then once you're done you go ahead and hit the save button. And if you want to change the background, which is the most important one, you go over to graphics, and from the graphics here you can be able to select any of the pre-downloaded background that came along with the software, and you can also use them as well if you want to. Okay, so you can use any of them as well. Now if you want to project the scripture maybe to your projector, you just go ahead and click on the screen. So this particular one here is the screen setup, you see. So can enable leave the stage presentation screen, this the main one, the main presentation screen. Okay, so you can use that this particular one as well. Now this is it, this the main one, and you can use the second stage, so whichever one you want to use. Just know that this is a quick review of the software, so I'm going to be making an in-depth tutorial on how you can be able to use the software put on vMix and a couple of other softwares that I talked about. And if you want to project to maybe to your second PC, you click on this place, the vast view here at the top here, you see the remote verse view here, so you can click on it, the remote verse view, if you want to send out to your second PC, or if you want to send into to vMix, you can also select that as well. Okay, so this is it, the remote control. You can use it to send out to your second PC, and you can also use it to send to your main PC. If you want to use it with vMix all in one PC, you can also use this to do that. Okay, so and that is it. And on the search, maybe you have anything you want to search, you can also do that. If you want to schedule maybe some scriptures or notes that you want to display on the screen, you can also do that as well. And I like the fact that it's actually very simple, so it's not difficult to understand. So by opening the software alone, you see everything the way they are, everything is just stated out there. If you want to on the song here, these are the songs that are available, the ones that are already pre-downloaded on the software. Okay, so you can add new ones. If you want to delete them, you can also go ahead and delete them as well. And here on the screen part, you can also set your background, maybe your stage style, how you want it. If you want it to be in lower third, I'm also going to be doing another video on how you can be able to display your scripture in lower third using this software. All right, so test them out and let me know what you think. Why I update you more on how you can be able to do the complex part using this Bible display and also your hymn display software called Verse.